In this screencast, we will explore dead time in the Laplace domain and the usage of the real translation theorem. To motivate it, we'll start with the problem provided below, where we're going to determine the inverse Laplace transform of the function provided. Looking at this, in the Laplace domain, dead time is always represented by the presence of an exponential in the S domain. So this represents dead time. The dead time, which is also known as the transportation lag, is a common occurrence in chemical processes. Why? The major reason is piping. So in large chemical plants, a fluid has to go from one point to another. However, these distances are oftentimes non-negligible. So therefore, a fluid that is at point A, in order for it to get to point B, it could take a couple minutes in order for this to happen. Therefore, the process is not acting in terms of changing. The input's effect on the output is not occurring. So therefore, that represents this lag time, which in a graphical standpoint can be somewhat represented like this, where this here is the dead time. And again, because chemical processes have significant piping or other means where nothing exactly is happening, where another example is some certain types of equipment, for example, gas chromatographs, there is a time it takes for the experiment to run before you can obtain a composition. Because of the importance of dead time in chemical processes, there is a theorem provided in the Laplace domain to handle dead time, and it is the real translation theorem, which is shown here. Where on the left-hand side, the Laplace of a function multiplied by a step function will equal the exponential times a function itself. Let's take a look at the real translation theorem and what information we can get from it. First, let's focus on this S term, the step function. And what this term tells us is that at times less than t0, the value of this step is going to be 0. So in other words, the term is 0. The entire term. Whereas for times greater than or equal to t0, s, the value of the step, will be 1, meaning that the value of this function will be the ft minus t0 part shown here. We can look at the effects on the right-hand side by looking at the graph above, where the dead time represents the exponential, the e to the negative st0, where dead time equals t0. The graph here would represent the function we would want to take the Laplace of. So looking at this equation, what does it mean in terms of how we apply this mathematically? Well, our focus here will be how to take an inverse Laplace transform. And the way we could do it is as such. Step one is to ignore the e to the negative st0 term. Step two is to take the inverse Laplace transform. And then step three is wherever e to the negative st0 is seen, you do the following. And there are two things that you're going to do. The first is replace t with t minus t0, and b, show that the term is valid only when t is greater than or equal to t0. And that can be done in one of two ways. It can be written either as the step function shown above, or in more common mathematical terms, like when t is greater than or equal to t0. Either way would be acceptable. With all this information provided about the real translation theorem and its utility for processes with dead time, now let's solve the original question given, which has been reprovided below. The first step is to break it into parts. When we do this, the 4 over 2s plus 1 term, when we take an inverse Laplace transform of this is not affected by dead time. So therefore, this will just act as a regular function, which it is, and therefore the inverse Laplace transform of this is the constant 4 multiplied by the exponential of negative t over 2. Now we will look at the term with the e to the negative 3s in it. If we follow the steps provided earlier, the first step is to ignore the e to the negative st0 term. In other words, this is 1 over 2s plus 1. The next step is to take the inverse Laplace transform. It's similar to the one we just did. So therefore, that will be e to the negative t over 2. Now we have to evaluate step 3. The first thing we do is replace t in this with t minus t0, where t0 is the dead time here, which is 3. And the next step is to show that this is valid only when t is greater than or equal to t0. So therefore, here we'll just write this as the step function of t minus 3, which indicates that this function is 0 when t is less than 3, and it's itself the exponential of t minus 3 over 2 when t is greater than or equal to 3. We now bring back the plus term to show the sum of these, and we get our final answers, which we'll represent in a few different ways. So the first way, which we've written with the step term in there, 4e to the negative t over 2 plus e to the negative t minus 3 over 2 times s to the t minus 3, or that y of t equals 4e to the negative t over 2 for times in between 0, where we've implied a change has occurred, to until the dead time ends at time equals 3. And then the entire function for all other times. An important point to note here is that these two functions are continuous because at t equals 3, this term will equal 0. The second answer shows that this is a continuous function, which is what we expect it to be.